Hey everybody and welcome. In this video, we are going to create a pickup entirely in blueprints that can affect our player character in some way. So let's go ahead and get started. I am using the blueprint first person template project, but you can use any project that you would like. For the purposes of this video, I did include starter content just so I have some things to work with. So I'm gonna hop down into the content browser here and into the props folder. And we have a bunch of different static meshes here. We're going to use one of these static meshes. So let's go ahead and let's just drag in a chair. This is going to serve as our pickup because picking up chairs are fun. And you can use any static mesh that you would like, but we're using the chair. And I'm actually going to play inside of the editor really quickly. I want to see something. If I play in the editor, I can shoot my chair and it blocks my projectiles. It also blocks me if I try to run through the chair. And usually with pickups, you can pass through the item and actually pick it up. For us, we're getting blocked by our chair. We don't want that. We want to be able to pass through it and pick the chair up. It's actually also not moving because it's not a physics object. So it's just blocking everything, essentially. So I made escape to exit the play session here. And I'm going to jump over to the details panel. And I'm going to scroll through it. And I'm going to find the collision section inside the details panel for my chair here. And there it is. And there's two options in here we want to worry about. The first is this collision presets. And as you can see, it's currently set to block all, block everything that bumps into this chair here. I'm going to click the drop down and we're going to change this. We're going to change this to overlap only pawn. So only pawns and characters, which characters are a subclass of pawns. So only pawns and characters can pass through this chair, which is what we want. The next thing that we're going to do is check this box here for generate overlap events. And this is going to tell us when something has overlapped this chair. So we need to know when something passes through this chair. So make sure that that is checked. And I'm going to hit play again just to make sure. Yep, blocks my projectiles, but I can pass through it, which is what we want. So I'm going to hit escape and hop back over to the details panel here. I'm going to click this blueprint add script button. This is going to create a blueprint out of this chair and allow us to add scripted behavior to that blueprint. So I'm going to go ahead and click that. It's going to ask me to give it a name. I'm just going to call it the chair blueprint here. Hit the create blueprint button. That's going to create a brand new blueprint for us inside the content browser. It's also going to open up a new tab here at the top. I'm going to go ahead and click that tab. And we are now inside the blueprint editor here. We're currently on the viewport tab of the blueprint editor, and you can see there's our chair. We only have one component in here, our chair. We don't have anything else in here. That's fine. We're actually going to jump over to the event graph because this is where we provide the scripted behavior for our blueprint. So on this graph, what we're going to do is hold down the right mouse button and drag these nodes here. These nodes are here by default. We're not going to touch any of these. We're just going to right click and drag those out of the way because we're going to create our own nodes here. And as you can see, it says right click to create new nodes. So we're just going to right click and release. And you're going to see we're going to get this context menu where we can add all the various blueprint nodes to provide functionality for this blueprint. For us, we need to find an overlap event. So let's go ahead and search for overlap. And if I scroll up to the top here, you can see for collision, there's an event actor begin overlap. There's also an end, but for us, we're just going to worry about this one, the event actor begin overlap. So go ahead and select that. It's going to give us a new node on our graph here. And this is the start of our script. Anything that is connected to this wire will get called whenever we overlap our chair in the level. So for us, the first thing that we're going to do, actually, let's right click again. And in the search, what we're going to search for is destroy. So we have a beginning node. Let's add our end node. And our end node is going to be to destroy the chair. So the destroy actor. Let's go ahead and select that. And you can see it says target is actor. And it wants us to specify a target. Currently, it's set to self, which is fine. That is this chair blueprint, which is our self. We want to destroy that when we overlap it. After we do some script here in the middle. And the script that we want to provide in the middle here is we're going to spawn an effect just to let us know that we have overlapped the chair. So let's go and do that. Let's right click in the graph here again. And we're going to search for spawn emitter. And we're going to choose the spawn emitter at location. So let's go ahead and select that. It's going to give us a new node. And let's connect all of our nodes here together. Let's connect the executable here and connect it to the end of our spawn node. We're just left clicking and dragging to connect the nodes. going to do the same here. Let's left click and drag and connect this here. You'll get the green check mark to let you know that you have connected it. So there we go. When we overlap the chair, spawn an effect, then destroy the chair. Now the last thing that we need to do is provide an effect for us to spawn and a location to spawn it. So let's go ahead and click this drop down here. Now because we included starter content, we have some starter particle effects that we can use. I'm going to go ahead and choose the explosion because explosions are always nice. If you don't have anything in here, you may have to create a particle effect or include starter content so that you have some stuff to work with. We're just going to use the explosion. And then off location here, you can see it's set to 0, 0, and 0 for the X, Y, and Z. We actually don't want that. We're going to drag off this location here, and we're going to say get actor location. And we're going to use the get actor location node, and that will connect it up for us. So let's move that over a little bit. And just like our destroy actor, it's looking for a target, an actor for the target, and it's saying self the same as our target for the destroy actor. So that's perfect. When overlapping the chair, get the location of the chair and provide that location to spawn our emitter and then destroy the chair blueprint. So we're going to compile and save, and then we're going to hop back over to our level here, and then we're going to hit play to play in the editor. I can shoot my chair and nothing happens, but when I run through it, boom, we destroy our chair with an explosion, and that is what we wanted. The last thing that we're going to do is provide some functionality for our player character to modify it actually when we go over this pickup. So let's hop back over to the blueprint. Let's move our destroy actor over just a little bit because we're going to provide some script here. And let's go to the event actor begin overlap node. Now you can see there's an other actor pin here. This is going to be really helpful for us actually. This other actor pin will tell us what it is that overlapped our chair. So we can find out what it is that overlapped our chair. So let's drag, left click and drag off of this and release. And we're going to search for something inside our context menu here. What we're going to search for is a cast node. And what the cast node is, the cast node will provide a way for us to check and make sure something is indeed something else. I guess that's the best way to put it. What we're going to do is search for cast to character. And what this does is say, is it a character that indeed overlapped the chair? So go ahead and select cast to character. Then let's drag that up here and let's reconnect some nodes here. Let's drag off this and connect that to that. Now our destroy actor has been disconnected. You can see we have two pins here, two out pins for our cast to character. For the cast failed, we don't really need to worry about that. In the event that it is not a character that has overlapped our chair, this cast failed would get called. We actually don't need to worry about that because if you recall, we hop back over here really quickly. We set this to overlap only pawn. So only pawns and characters can overlap it. So we really don't need to worry about the cast fail because nothing's going to happen. But for the success pin, we do need to provide some script in here to occur when a player character or pawn has overlapped the chair. So what we're going to do, we're going to drag off the as character pin here. As the character that overlapped our chair, let's do something here. Let's go ahead and search for get character movement. And if I scroll all the way down to the bottom, there's our get character movement. Let's go ahead and select that. And what this is all the scripted functionality that pertains to character movement for characters. So what we're going to do, let's move our node over just a little bit more. I keep moving you out of the way because you're getting in my way. What we're going to do is drag off the character movement pin here, and we're going to search for walk speed. Let's search for walk speed. And we get a bunch of options here, and the one that we're going to use is set max walk speed. This is the maximum speed a character can walk inside of our game. And let's connect the success to the end of our set, like so. And then let's connect the out to the destroy. Right now it is set to 0 for our player character. Now we have a default walk speed. I'm not quite sure what it is off the top of my head. I think it's like 400 or 500, maybe 600. Just to make sure to see that our script is working, I'm gonna bump this way up to 1500. So if I zoom out, let's walk through it again really quickly. When I overlap the chair, get the location of the chair and spawn an effect. If it is a character that has overlapped our chair, go ahead and proceed to this and get the character movement, set the walk speed of that character to 1500, then destroy the chair blueprint. So let's compile and save and test that. Hop back over to our level and play. And I can shoot my chair, but you can see I'm moving around at this speed. When I go over our chair, boom, it explodes, and I am going super fast now, which is cool to run super fast like this. So there you go. That is how you create a pickup in Blueprints and have it affect your player character in some way. Thank you guys for watching, and we hope you enjoyed it.